कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म, कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म। सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम ऑफ द सेम टॉपिक, दैट इज दिस मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस ऑन कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म। नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हियर, व्हाट इज द साइट फॉर ग्लूकोनियोजेनेसिस, what is this site for gluconeogenesis? Friends, now all of you know that what is meant by gluconeogenesis. So synthesis or formation of glucose from the non-carbohydrate substances, that is called as gluconeogenesis. Okay, all of you know that. Now the first option for this question is liver, then B option is blood, then C option is muscles, and D option is brain. So the friends, correct answer of this question is A option, that is liver. So liver, it is the site for gluconeogenesis or synthesis of glucose from the non-carbohydrate substances. We also know that there is another site for this gluconeogenesis, and that is nothing but the cortex of the kidney, but there is a maximum glucose is synthesized or formed in liver, and later on that up to lesser extent that glucose is also formed in cortex of kidney. Okay, so and if you think about these muscles, so these muscles, it is the site for glycogenesis. Okay, it is the site for glycogenesis, that is synthesis of glycogen. Okay, when there is a extra glucose is there, or at that time this extra glucose get converted to glycogen, and that is takes place in this muscles. So is question se bhi aap ek char paanch questions yahan pe bana sakte ho alag alag prakar ke. So this is about our first question. Now the second question is, which of the following is not the precursor of, which of the following is not the precursor of, not the precursor of gluconeogenesis. Okay, so the first option is glycolytic compounds, B option is citric acid cycle intermediates, C option is glucogenic amino acids, and D option is lysine or leucine. So the correct answer of this question is D option, that is lysine or leucine. This is the second question here. Which of the following is not the precursor of gluconeogenesis? The first option is glycolytic compounds. B option is citric acid cycle intermediates. Then C option is glucogenic amino acids, and D option is lysine or leucine. Friends, the correct answer of this question is D option, that is lysine and leucine. These are not the precursors for gluconeogenesis. Now in last lecture we have seen about that question was on gluconeogenesis, and here we will see about that different types of precursors which are used for the synthesis of glucose, that is called as gluconeogenesis. So friends, now we know that whatever this glucose is synthesized here, that glucose, it is synthesized by a process called as gluconeogenesis. So that process is called as gluconeogenesis, and here, so whatever that precursors are used for the synthesis of glucose, that precursors are non-carbohydrates. That means these are not carbohydrates. Instead of that, these are other compounds, but these are not carbohydrates. So which are that compounds, I will show here by a simple diagram. One diagram I will draw here, so from that you will easily get these non-carbohydrate precursors used for gluconeogenesis. So here, see, this is the phosphoenol pyruvate. Just I will draw the diagram here. Phosphoenol pyruvate. So this phosphoenol pyruvate, actually it is a one product of glycolysis, phosphoenol pyruvate. So here this is the reversible reaction here. So I will show like this reversible reaction. So aspartate and aspargine, these are the amino acids, aspartate and aspargine. Aspartate and aspargine. So these are the two amino acids here. Now these amino acids, these are glucogenic amino acids. Actually these are amino acids, so these are the non-carbohydrates, and these are glucogenic. It means these act as the precursors for the synthesis of glucose. So here, so this phosphoenol pyruvate, later on, see, this is the glucose here. Glucose get converted to phosphoenol pyruvate, and these two amino acids, just I was told here that one is aspartate and second one is here aspargine. Okay, aspartate and aspargine, so they get converted to oxaloacetate, and later on, so first this phosphoenol pyruvate, this oxaloacetate, again it get converted to this phosphoenol pyruvate, and at the same time, whatever this phosphoenol pyruvate here, later on, that is in glycolysis, get converted to pyruvic acid or pyruvate. All of you know that it get converted to pyruvate, and this pyruvate get converted to oxaloacetate, that is in TCA cycle, and at the same time it get converted to acetyl coenzyme A, acetyl coenzyme A, and this acetyl coenzyme A later on enters into TCA cycle. So that is oxaloacetate. So here later on get converted to citrate. So here this is the citrate. Then later on these are the intermediate product here, isocitrate. Now this is called as isocitrate. Then after that this isocitrate get converted to alpha ketoglutarate. So it get converted to alpha ketoglutarate, alpha ketoglutarate. So this is alpha ketoglutarate, and again it get converted to succinyl coenzyme A, succinyl coenzyme A, and this succinyl coenzyme A later on get converted to succinate, get converted to succinate. Then it get converted to fumarate, succinate get converted to fumarate, and this fumarate get converted to malate. This is called as the TCA cycle, and finally this malate get converted to oxaloacetate. So there will be cycle here in this way. So here now whatever this fumarate is there, now there is a amino acids, there are some amino acids such as tyrosine, that is one is here. So these amino acids, that is tyrosine, phenylalanine and aspartate, tyrosine, phenylalanine, phenylalanine and aspartate, phenylalanine and aspartate, they get converted to this fumarate, and in this way that fumarate enters into this TCA cycle, and later on it get converted to glucose. So fumarate, malate, oxaloacetate, then this phosphoenolpyruvate and glucose. So in this way these amino acids, they enters into the TCA cycle and they involved in the gluconeogenesis. So these are the non-carbohydrate here. So in this, these aspartate and aspargine also, oxaloacetate, then later on they get converted to this phosphoenolpyruvate and then glucose. Then again there are another amino acids which get converted to succinyl coenzyme A, and these amino acids includes which get converted to succinyl coenzyme A, that is threonine. So these amino acids are threonine, then methionine, methionine, then isoleucine, isoleucine and valine. So these amino acids, they get converted to, these amino acids, they get converted to this succinyl coenzyme A. Okay, then another amino acid is here which get converted to alpha ketoglutarate, and that is called as glutamate. That amino acid is known as glutamate amino acid. Okay, so this glutamate get converted to alpha ketoglutarate or alpha ketoglutarate, and then it get converted to succinyl coenzyme A. In this way it get converted to finally glucose. So there are another amino acids which get converted to first glutamate and then to alpha ketoglutarate, and that amino acids are arginine, these are arginine, then proline, proline, then histidine, histidine, then glutamine. So these amino acids, they first get converted to glutamate, and then this glutamate get converted to this alpha keto glutarate. Okay, so there are another amino acids are here which get converted to acetyl coenzyme A. So These amino acids includes which get converted to acetyl coenzyme A. That amino acids are tryptophan. So this is the tryptophan amino acids which get converted to acetyl coenzyme A. Then later on tyrosine. Then later on phenylalanine. Then threonine. Then isoleucine. Then lysine and leucine. Okay, but here these lysine and leucine, these are ketogenic amino acids. Just keep in mind here, these lysine and leucine, these are ketogenic amino acids. And these ketogenic amino acids, these are not involved in the, though these are non-carbohydrate, but these ketogenic amino acids, these are not involved in ketogenic amino acids, these are not involved in gluconeogenesis. इसीलिए हमारे क्वेश्चन का जो आंसर है वो डी ऑप्शन है, दैट इज ल्यूसिन एंड लाइसिन. तो दीज आर किटोजेनिक एंड देयर फोर दीज आर नॉट इन्वॉल्व इन द ग्लूकोनियोजेनेसिस. बट दी अनदर अमाइनो एसिड्स हियर दैट मे बी जस्ट आई हैव टोल्ड हियर, ऑल दीज आर किटोजेनिक, सम आर किटोजेनिक, सम आर, दैट इज दीज आर ग्लूकोजेनिक एज वेल एज किटोजेनिक. सो दे आर ग्लूकोजेनिक, दैट्स वाई दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन द gluconeogenesis. Okay, and another one is here, that another amino acids which are first get converted to pyruvic acid or pyruvate, and then they enters into the, or they get converted to oxaloacetate later on, and in this way again they get converted to glucose. So these amino acids which get converted to pyruvate, that includes alanine, glycine, threonine. So these includes, these amino acids are alanine, these are glycine, then threonine, then cysteine, then serine and tryptophan. So these amino acids, they get converted to pyruvate, from pyruvate to oxaloacetate. So in this way they enters into the TCA cycle, and from oxaloacetate they get converted to this phosphoenolpyruvate and phosphoenolpyruvate to glucose. So this is about gluconeogenesis. So except these lysine and leucine, all amino acids are glucogenic, we can see here, and therefore they act as the precursors for the synthesis of glucose by a process called as gluconeogenesis. So isliye hamare jo question ka answer hai wo answer hai, that is D option, because these lysine and leucine, these are not precursors. So these are not the precursors of gluconeogenesis. Okay, so question number third is, see the next question, name the enzyme. See the next question is, next question, that is name the enzyme. Question number 3, name the enzyme which is responsible for, name the enzyme, name the enzyme which is responsible for, responsible for the conversion of pyruvate, responsible for the conversion, conversion of pyruvate, conversion of pyruvate to phosphoenol pyruvate, conversion of pyruvate to phosphoenol, phosphoenol pyruvate. So what is the question here? Name the enzyme which is responsible for the conversion of pyruvate to phosphoenol pyruvate. Option A is pyruvate carboxylase, pyruvate carboxylase. ऑप्शन बी इज पायरुवेट कार्बोक्सीकाइनेज, पायरुवेट कार्बोक्सीकाइनेज, पायरुवेट कार्बोक्सीकाइनेज एंड ऑप्शन सी इज ग्लूकोज सिक्स फॉस्फेटेस, ग्लूकोज सिक्स फॉस्फेटेस, ग्लूकोज सिक्स फॉस्फेटेस एंड ऑप्शन डी इज फॉस्फोफ्रुक्टोकाइनेज, फॉस्फो फ्रुक्टो काइनेज. ओके, सो दीज आर द ऑप्शंस एंड द करेक्ट ऑप्शन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज पायरुवेट कार्बोक्सीकाइनेज. सो फ्रेंड्स, द करेक्ट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज पायरुवेट कार्बोक्सीकाइनेज. एंड दिस पायरुवेट कार्बोक्सीकाइनेज, इट इज एन एंजाइम विच कन्वर्ट्स दिस पायरुवेट टू फॉस्फोइनॉल पायरुवेट, दैट इज फॉस्फोइनॉल पायरुवेट. So, or PEP, we can say in short here, that is called as PEP or phosphoenol pyruvate. So, this question, it is related to that important pathway which is called as gluconeogenesis. ये जो question है, एक important pathway से related है और उस pathway का नाम है gluconeogenesis. और अभी हमें what is mean by gluconeogenesis, ये हमें पता है. So this is related to this gluconeogenesis. और gluconeogenesis क्या है, we know that. फिर भी मैं आपको यहाँ पे बताऊँ कि this formation or synthesis of glucose from non-carbohydrate substances or precursors, that is called as gluconeogenesis. ठीक है, and this process, that is a multi-step, which is a multi-step process in which that pyruvate or gluconeogenesis, we know that it is a multi-step process, and here that pyruvate, which is a end product of glycolysis, that is pyruvate or other three carbon compounds, pyruvate and other three carbon compounds, that is for example that here lactate or alanine, for example lactate, that is lactic acid, lactate or alanine, these compounds, they get converted to glucose. There is another compounds are also there which are non-carbohydrate, they get converted to glucose. So this question is related to gluconeogenesis, and we know what is meant by gluconeogenesis. Now the seven steps of gluconeogenesis are catalyzed by the same enzymes. Seven steps of this gluconeogenesis process or pathway, these are catalyzed by the same enzymes. These are catalyzed by same enzymes of, catalyzed by the same enzymes which are used in, same enzymes. These are catalyzed by the same enzymes of ग्लाइकोलाइसिस. मतलब ग्लाइकोलाइसिस में ये जो सात एंजाइम्स हैं, वही एंजाइम ग्लूकोनियोजेनेसिस में यूज होते हैं फॉर दैट मेटाबॉलिक पाथवे टू ऑकर. ओके, एंड ये जो एंजाइम्स यहाँ पे सेवन एंजाइम्स यूज हो रहे हैं, ऑल दीज स्टेप्स आर रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन. ओके, सो दीज आर ऑल दीज स्टेप्स, दीज आर रिवर्सिबल, एंड दैट्स वाई these are the same steps in the gluconeogenesis as well as glycolysis, but these are the reversal, these are the reversal in the gluconeogenesis, so that's why the enzymes are same. Okay, and these three steps which are bypassed, because that three steps are different in gluconeogenesis, and that three steps includes, the first one is here conversion of pyruvate to phosphoenol pyruvate. So this is the one here, conversion of pyruvate to phosphoenol pyruvate, then which is catalyzed by the that it is conversion of pyruvate to phosphoenol pyruvate via oxaloacetate, via oxaloacetate, and it is catalyzed by pyruvate carboxylase and pyruvate carboxykinase. So that's why the answer of this question is that B option, and the name of that enzyme is pyruvate carboxykinase. Okay, so here today we will stop. Friends, if you are not subscribed this channel, kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte. Watch this whole videos, comment as well as share with your friends. Thank you.